I've always been interested in accents and dialects and how they change. And I mean, Scotland is, although it's a small country, it's absolutely fascinating how, you know, I mentioned Glasgow, how with Glasgow there's a sort of scoop and rise intonation pattern, you know. There's that kind of feel, they stretch their vowels out in Glasgow. And then as you go up the Highlands, it's a little bit lighter. You can hear the Gaelic processes, aspiration and devoicing coming into the speech. It's a lovely day up there, and it all gets a little bit more softened if you're over in the Hebrides. But then once you come over to sort of Inverness way, it tightens up. You get the retroflex R, where the tongue tip curls back, and there's a little bit more twang to the voice like that. And then over on the East Coast, Aberdeen, it's back of the mouth. Somebody once told me they thought it's because there are strong winds coming off the North Sea, so the voice goes back and you don't open your mouth too wide, and it all tends to go up into the nose like that. And then, you know, if you come down towards Dundee, you'll still get a bit of that kind of back of the mouth feel. But the distinctive thing about the Dundee dialect is that the I sound flattens to A, so the personal pronoun I becomes A. So I ate a pie would be ate a pie, I ate a pie. And then in Edinburgh, it's just it's more sort of back of the mouth, like a little bit like a sort of rev an engine like that. But if you're going, I mean, you've also got to think about one of the things that you think about when you're working on accent and dialect is the status of the character. So Ned, our Edinburgh lawyer, he's not talking like that. He's not talking like, you know, a lower class Edinburgh person, or working class Edinburgh person, I should say. But so he's a little bit more refined, and it's a little bit, the tongue is a little bit flatter, and it's a little bit more douce, I would say.